Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Science Museum. Alice came into this gallery, met me. We were talking about something that she's complained about endlessly in articles and books. And it sort of struck me, well, why doesn't she come up with the perfect Alice? Now, I can't wait to see what is behind that curtain. It's now time to introduce Alice Roberts.
Thanks, Roger. So this has been an extraordinary project. I've been terribly excited about this for a month, but I'm also really nervous, and I'm interested to see what you think as well. Okay, right, help me with this then. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh my goodness. Oh. Oh no, I can't look at her. Oh, this is really strange. She's so different and yet in some ways so realistic.
The thing I find weirdest is the face, actually, because it does look like my face, but those eyes have changed the geometry of it. No, it's not the weirdest thing, is it? The baby's the weirdest thing. That is the weirdest thing. But it's very, very cute at the same time. Ah!
Alice 2.0 is amazing. To counter the faults of our flawed transition to standing upright, she's got a chimp's sturdy lower back and the shock-absorbing legs of an emu. To improve blood circulation, she's got tiny pumps in her thighs. Beneath her breastless chest lies the reliable heart of a dog and the graceful lungs of a swan. Her neck houses a choke-proof windpipe. And to ensure a pain-free childbirth, she nurtures her baby in a marsupial pouch. Her senses have been transformed with large mobile ears and light-sensitive, supersized eyes. This could be a human fit for the future.